अहमद हसन
सर, द अगस्त 6, 2001 ए फायर ब्रोक आउट इन एन असाइलम इन इरवादी तमिलनाडु. मोर देन 25 पेशेंट्स वेर बर्न्ड अलाइव. दे कुड नॉट एस्केप द ब्लेज एज दे हैड बीन चेन्ड टू पोल्स और बेड्स. द सुप्रीम कोर्ट स्टेटेड दैट द मेंटल हेल्थ एक्ट 1987 इज नॉट एट ऑल इम्प्लीमेंटेड बाय द कंसर्न अथॉरिटीज एंड देयर इज फेलियर on the part of the central and state governments to implement the 1987 act. Thus there is an urgent need to introduce and implement sweeping reforms in this regard in the country. The National Human Rights Commission has conducted a detailed studies of patient in mental health institution and the condition they live in. They found numerous instances of cruel treatment and people being chained, being beaten and being denied any kind of dignity. Sir, there are around 4,000 psychiatrists in India and many of them are in private practice. Thus, there is a massive shortage of psychiatrists in the public sector and in the rural area. This has led to a large number of people requiring mental health care remaining undiagnosed. As per NCRB data, 1,31,666 people committed suicide in India in 2014. Depression is the leading cause of suicide around the world and needs to be treated by healthcare professionals. And sir, there is a need to eliminate the social stigma associated with the mental disorder. Access to the mental health services in India continues to be a major challenge, as up to 40% of the patients travel more than 20 kilometers to access district mental health program services. Coming to the Mental Health Care Bill 2013, it has some good provisions. Any person with or without mental illness can make an advance directive or AD stating how he or she wishes to be treated for a future mental illness and also how he does not wish to be treated. Such an AD can also be challenged by families, professionals, etc. Decriminalization of suicide is a much needed reform. A person attempting suicide shall be considered to be under severe stress and will not be liable to be prosecuted under Section 309 of Indian Penal Code. The government should provide care, treatment, rehabilitation to all such persons. The bill states that it is the obligation of the central and state governments to build halfway homes, community caring center, among other things, for the mentally ill. Such services should be affordable, of good quality, and available without discrimination. The bill also provides protection to patients from cruel, inhuman, and degrading treatment. In the new bill, some treatment currently being practiced will be prohibited. Most importantly, electroconvulsive therapy given without anesthesia and the practice of chaining patients to their beds. However, there are some issues with the bill which I would like to raise. The provision of the appointing a nominee and then all subsequent decision being taken by the nominee may lead to damaging the goodwill and bonding between a family. Furthermore, a person can only be admitted to a mental health care facility after being reviewed by the MHRC. This might cause undue delay in the treatment and will make the entire process more complicated. This reason might discourage families from playing a protective role in seeking treatment. Sir, the MHRC has 6 members, out of which only one is a psychiatrist and another is a mental health care professional. This will lead to crucial decisions being taken in the field of mental health by non-experts. The bill allows for ECT on minors in case the psychiatrist advises it, with the consent of the guardian and prior permission of the board. However, due to extreme side effects and its controversial practice in the treatment of mental illness in minors, a blanket ban on ECT or a blanket ban on ECT for minors should be implemented as recommended by the World Health Organization. Sir, it is surprising that the bill provides for only one district board for the 8 northeastern states of India, covering an area of 262,230 square kilometers. It would make it inaccessible to a majority of the people in these states who face difficulties in connectivity. Sir, I would urge the government to look into these issues and make necessary changes so that India gets a progressive law on mental health care, which would work towards raising awareness and eradicating the stigma attached to the mentally ill people. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. I am here to remind it word to word, reading is not allowed. I'm not going to disturb anybody, but according to Parliament etiquette, word to word reading is not allowed. So please,